close. Now Anthony Obam has a good front leg. Good, very good front leg. It's like he has a radar, like a scanner.
I think that looked
the
like
other.
Did he grab? Teach. No, I don't think he grabbed
yes.
either.
And maybe. In,
no.
A touch and hold, perhaps.
You see?
Really?
No.
No, I don't think
so. He touched it?
Very close. Very close. I wouldn't like to be the video referee on this one.
Oh, oh, yes, I think from that angle, yeah.
From this?
And
oh,
this
yeah.
one. Ooh, yeah.
Lovely.
This will be a great story, though, if Anthony wins this World Championship. So the silence will be wonderful.
Only 1 minute.
Yeah, exactly.
Only 1 minute of this final.
David Cooper almost lost his tie there in the centre of the ring, but it is a significant moment in this match.
That would have made it interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
He's in fire.
He wants it.
Yeah, Mardani just easing into that distance, walking in, trying to cover.
I think Iran's a little bit wary to go in with that front leg because...
The reverse.
Yeah, Anthony has that exactly there. Oh, two points there. To the back as well. To the back of the body. When they were juniors, seniors, and he has the same. Just, they're all there cheering for Gabon. This is such... an amazing fight.
Well, it's underway now, the third and potentially final round here of the men's heavyweight. Good attempt from Mardani.
A little bit hard,
not enough commitment there from Iran.
Lacked conviction, lacked accuracy, and good cover from Anthony Obami, trying to hang on to this 4-point lead, but he can't be too passive.
That was very beautiful. The precision was exceptional.
He's going to have to fight 7-2. Now. He's got a minute and 20 seconds left. He's going to battle all the way for this one. He came into the match injured. A heavy blow to the hand. Blood and guts required. There's the front leg hook again.
Oh, wow.
Beautiful.
A little bit controversial, but it doesn't matter, though, you know. I think it would be difficult for the Iranian to pull this back anyway.
Yeah, for sure.
Samos. Maybe Samos should go on the podium, I think, with Anthony together.
I think he will jump from the...
I think he's definitely going to go onto the ring.
Well,
no mistake.
There's still some time. Let's focus. Because Anthony Obam has to be very careful. Mardani has given
seconds.
His best. It's 10 seconds from glory here. Obam has had this situation before.
Play with the leg.
Little bit of history here. The crowd counts it down. Let's look at it. 2013 WTF Heavyweight Champion.
Get up there.
It's so beautiful.
That's amazing. It's amazing. There he is. Go on, Ramos. Go on.
His mother is here.
Really?
Yeah. So he has his family here
in the public.
When Antonio Ramos was so emotional, you can see what it means
so
to him.
So beautiful, beautiful.
He did a lot. Every day he trained himself.
Wow.
Fantastic relationship between coach and player.
Yeah.
And a great fight from Mardani. He gave it all the good.
He did. You know what? Anthony was just a different class.
Yeah.
It was a different class. And, you know, the Iranian athlete, I think, should be happy with his performance. I think he did his best. But I think no one could beat Anthony today.
He did the perfect thing.
Je suis très satisfait parce que j'ai disputé beaucoup de finales. J'ai fait la Coupe du Gabon, j'ai fait médaille d'argent, les Jeux africains, médaille d'argent, les championnats du monde universitaire, médaille d'argent, les Jeux olympiques de Londres l'année dernière, médaille d'argent. Et je suis content aujourd'hui d'avoir mon premier titre de champion du monde.
Quel était le moment le plus difficile aujourd'hui?
Le moment le plus difficile, c'était tous les combats. Tous les combats, surtout le premier combat où il fallait se mettre dans le bain, il fallait rentrer dans la compétition tout de suite, j'ai gagné d'un seul point et c'est vrai que je me suis senti meilleur au fur et à mesure que j'avançais, mais je peux dire que tous les moments étaient difficiles, tous les combats étaient difficiles, à leur niveau bien sûr.
Bon, le petit pas de danse là, c'était quoi?
C'était un petit pas de danse de chez moi qu'on appelle le jazzé. C'est une danse qu'on a de mon pays, le Gabon. Et tous mes coéquipiers qui me supportaient aujourd'hui, ils l'ont reconnu. Et certains Français, parce que je vis en France et je leur montre souvent. Et c'était une manière de leur faire une petite dédicace.
Est-ce qu'il y a d'autres objectifs après ce championnat du monde?
Bien sûr, bien sûr. Je prépare les prochains dans 2 ans. Et ensuite, les Jeux Olympiques, la médaille d'or que je n'ai pas pu avoir, et j'essaierai de la reconquérir. Et une fois, si j'arrive à la conquérir, et j'essaierai de redoubler la mise, c'est-à-dire encore champion du monde, encore champion olympique. Tant que j'aurai les capacités de pouvoir le faire, parce que c'est ce que j'aime, et j'essaierai toujours.
Congratulations again, thank you very much.
Thank you, you're welcome.